Hello. I am Dr. Nicole Calloway Rankins. I am a board certified OBGYN with nearly 15 years experience, as well as a certified integrative health coach. And in today's helpful tip, I am going to talk about things that you can do in order to relieve those pesky aches and discomforts that can happen during pregnancy. Now, there are a lot of changes that happen in your body in order to accommodate a growing pregnancy. And one of the things, one of the hormones in particular called relaxin, helps to relax your ligaments, helps to relax your joints, especially in your pelvis, in order to make room for your growing baby, and also to make space for your baby to be born. Now, one of the unfortunate sort of pesky side effects of those changes can be pain, especially lower back pain. Now, here's the thing. Those pains are common, but they don't have to be a part of your normal. One of the things that I don't think we necessarily do very well within OBGYN, particularly physicians, is helping women with ways to deal with that discomfort. A lot of times we may just say, you know, just kind of as part of pregnancy, sort of suck it up, but it doesn't have to be that way. So here are some things that you can do to relieve that pesky back pain. Number one is movement. The more you move on a regular basis, the less likely you are to develop those pains, and they can also help reduce the intensity of the pains if it comes. This doesn't have to be anything fancy. It can be something as simple as taking a 10 or 15 minute walk once a day, at least 3 or 4 times a week, to help keep your body moving, okay? One of the ways of movement that I think is especially helpful is prenatal yoga. So definitely look into a prenatal yoga class in your community. Doing that once a week or so can be extremely helpful to help relieve some of those common pregnancy aches and discomforts. I actually had a prenatal yoga expert on my podcast, All About Pregnancy and Birth. This was episode 30, and this was Gina Lurie, and that's ncrcoaching.com/episode30. And she talked all about prenatal yoga, and she even made a video of some things that you can do during pregnancy in order to help relieve those discomforts. And you can find that video again at ncrcoaching.com/episode30. All right, now some other things that you can do are heat, but not super duper hot. You want to more keep it actually warm as opposed to super duper hot on the heat. So a nice warm bath can be very helpful to sort of relieve those aches and discomforts from pregnancy. You don't want the water to be super hot, especially in the first trimester, because that may increase the risk of miscarriage. So just keep it as a nice warm bath. I tend to say don't use the bubbles and the bath salts. Just keep the water plain. I don't have any scientific evidence that shows that these things, the bubbles and the bath salts and those fragrant things in the water, harm pregnancy in any way. But I like to just keep it simple, just plain old warm water. If you want to add some ambiance or energy around it, then do like scented candles in order to do that, as opposed to putting stuff in the water. So, nice warm bath, perfectly fine and helpful during pregnancy to relieve those aches. You can also use a heating pad on your back and just keep it on a low setting. Again, you don't want to keep it super duper hot, so heating pad on your back is totally fine. The other thing that can work really well are maternity belts. Those are belts that you can get on Amazon, Target, Walmart, and they're like wide belts that you wrap around your belly, and they help kind of give a little bit of extra support underneath that growing belly, and that may reduce your back pain and discomfort. So definitely try a maternity belt as well. Now, the good thing about maternity belts is they're not just good during pregnancy, they are also great in the postpartum period as well. I wore them after both of my C-sections, and I just felt like they were really helpful in order to help me feel like more together, so to speak. So maternity belt will be an investment, not just for your pregnancy, but you can use it after delivery as well. And then also another thing you may want to consider is physical therapy. If it's super duper bad, then talk to your doctor, your midwife, about potentially seeing a physical therapist who is experienced in caring for women during pregnancy. Also, a prenatal chiropractor may be beneficial during pregnancy as well. I had a prenatal chiropractor on the podcast, Elliot Berlin. This was episode number 44. So ncrcoaching.com/episode44. And he talked about prenatal chiropractic care and how to find someone, what the benefits are, what that looks like. So you can check out that podcast episode as well. Both with the physical therapist and the prenatal chiropractor, again, I recommend someone who is specific or has training in caring for women during pregnancy. Okay, so that's it. So just to recap the things that you can try in order to help relieve those pregnancy discomforts are movement, simple exercise, walking, prenatal yoga, the maternity belt, a little bit of heat with a warm bath or a heating pad are fine, and then physical therapy or a prenatal chiropractor can be helpful as well. All right, so that's it. I hope you found it helpful. Do let me know in the comments if you've had trouble with pregnancy discomforts and aches and pains and what you did that worked for you. All right, I'll see you next time.